and see what he can do in the midst of unbelievers, on the leading edge with his word, his power, his grace, and his mercy. For God's sakes, we're Lutheran. This is what we know.
Wittenberg Project, coming up on the 4th of July, I watched this documentary called The American Gospel. It was pretty good. It did a good job of highlighting like the flaws and things of that nature. But for honest, it pretty much was, it was targeted at Pentecostals and charismatics in a sense. And it kind of felt like they were picking on easy targets. Easy targets. Like you're trying to pick on the person who you think you can fight the most. You know what I'm saying? Like the little person in the crowd.
Oh, so you want to be annihilated. All right. You all know the rules. It's one at a time. And I don't want to see anyone trying to cheat. You, the onion lady, come here. Uh-huh. You think you're so tough? I'll tell you what. You take the first crack. Put it right here.
Do you lift weights?
No, honey. I raise cattle.
Lucky for you, you're important to the economy. Now get back in line.
Nutcase.
What? You watch your mouth. Thank your stars you're a woman, otherwise... Yeah, with your mouth hanging open. Yeah, you, shrimp. You look like you could use some sense knocked into your head. You want to try? Okay. If there's one thing that really bugs the hell out of me, it's cheating. Set! Yeah, with glasses, you look mean enough. Come here. Whoa, whoa, back off. Whoever asked you. I was pointing at him over there. You, Karate Kid. You look okay. Let's see what you got. No, no, I don't give lessons. What?
Evil person, you know. I want to fight you. Yeah, you. You know. But I think they could have delved in a lot more. Like, what is the American gospel? One of the tenets I say, individualism. It's all about you. It's all about your walk, your faith, you. That's it. Not about the community. The gathering of saints is something that's not really viewed as that important in a sense. It's all about you, solo scriptura. I pick my Bible up, I read whatever I want. I decide whatever I want means. That's it, just me. Like whatever I come up with is what I come up with. Ignore the total history of the church, saints and things of that nature. What I say is right, what I say is go, what I say goes. If the pastor or if 2,000 years of church history disagrees, who cares? Keep it moving. The American gospel, 100% individualism. You'll see sermons, and I'm not pro-socialism, but you'll see sermons about how socialism is evil and things of that nature. If you believe in this type of stuff, communism, you're going to hell. Pretty much, when you start talking like that, you're kind of saying capitalism is the Christian way, as if the Bible is about that. The Bible is about Jesus. It's 100% individualism and things of that nature that they build upon overall in Americanism. You know, not about community, it's all about myself. I mean, you'll see things like, we'll talk about charity, but they'll always throw a disclaimer out there like, now not saying you have to go help everybody, you know? As if someone really thought that you were, when you say charity, you meant me give my rent check to somebody, and now I'm the person begging for a rent check. No one thought that, but you have to throw it out there so they know that, you know, hey, you know, soften the law. They want to soften the law in a sense. Individualism is a big characteristic of the American gospel. Like the whole goal of a sermon is, what did I get out of it? What did I get out of it? That's it. That's all that matters. You know what I'm saying? And like we all confess, or most of us, I'll say, sola scriptura. But then we throw out passages like 2 Thessalonians 2:15, where it says respect the traditions orally or verbally, basically the writings or stuff they pass down of the church. We totally disregard that because what we want to do is what we want to do. So I don't really have to care about the traditions of the past, the views of the past. It's all about us. It's all about us. Which leads me to my next tenet of the American gospel, Western supremacy, as if we're better than the Eastern church. we totally, as I mentioned before, for individualism, we totally disregard the history of the faith. Majority of churches don't even confess the ecumenical creeds. You go to their statement of faith page, and it's something they came up with as a church body. More individualism. More, we did this. We got this right. Like the West can't err, the West can leave, go wherever they want to, and wherever they go to, they're going to be Christianity. I've heard people say, oh, the West, we saved Christianity. We saved Christianity. It's literally amazing. I mean, people don't even recognize the ecumenical councils. Not just the creeds, but the councils. And when you look at the councils, you'll see, if you look at the attendees, the Council of Nicaea, by far, was more represented by the Eastern Church. Saints from Africa, Asia, places like that, was there laying the foundations that we all hold to. All hold to. The second council, the first one was Nicaea. Next council, Constantinople. The West was barely even there. Barely even there. But we treat Christianity as if it's not the West, it's just some heretics. It's some heretics. I've seen popular blogs pretty much, when the Coptics were getting their heads chopped off, just condemn all of them in a sense. Like, oh, they're not Christian. What? Total, like, it's like we think we're better than them. You know? And I don't know where they get this notion from. I mean, I got an idea, but it's a ridiculous notion. As if millions upon millions of saints are just disregarded. There's some people who, anybody you mention, John Chrysostom, John Damascus, they look at them like, oh, those are Catholics, they ain't Christian. What? Like, if it's not part of Western history, we totally disavow it. As if Christianity just started in the 1500s and everything before that was error. Or we nitpick and choose. Like people will, Augustine. A lot of traditions will grab onto one part of what Augustine teaches, disregard 90% of his theological convictions, which represented the majority of the church at the time. Western supremacy is another aspect of the American gospel that should be addressed, man. It's not cool. Another tenet of the American gospel, nationalism. Nationalism. Yes, we're called to, first off, this isn't about Donald Trump or Obama, Crip or Blood, Democrat or Republican. It's not about that. But part of the American gospel is nationalism, where literally we'll allow political figures to get in the pulpit and give a word to the congregation that has nothing to do with Jesus, nothing to do with forgiveness of sins, nothing to do with life, death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior. In church, we'll let them get up there, and sometimes you'll see American flags in the background. You'll see things like that, you know? Now, yes, wherever God placed you at for your life, your vocation, the nature, you're there. You're there. But that has nothing to do with Christianity. You know, I'm not sure why people have politicians, senators, not just presidents. You have senators, congresspeople come in there and they want to talk about various things. Yo, save that for after the service. After the service, you get it in, go talk about that. Because we are called to do things in this world. We are called for various things of that nature. But when it's church time, yo, if it ain't Christ crucified, you got to miss me with that. Take that somewhere else. Take that somewhere else. But it's 100% nationalism. We almost view our Christianity as part of America. More years, come on everybody, more years, come on everybody, more years. Woo! You know? And it's not. You're a Christian even if you get deported. You know what I'm saying? No matter where you are, like your tenets shouldn't change. Your morals, your ethics, and your stances shouldn't change based on what country you're loyal to. You see what I'm saying? Like, nationalism is definitely a big part of the American gospel. People representing sola Americana more than they are recognizing the historic faith once given. And America is not the gospel. The Constitution of the United States is not the gospel. The Bill of Rights is not the gospel. It's not. Sorry, I mean, it might offend a couple of you guys, you know what I'm saying? It's not. I could go all day with this. The American gospel, another tenet of it. Something I like to call faith in faith. Like, we all depend on our, goes back to individualism also, that's a big thing. How strong is my faith? Rather than focusing on the means of grace, where God said he'll be at, where he's gonna meet you at, things like baptism, the Lord's Supper, God empowering and emboldening you, and things of that nature. It's more so about, well, first off, in the American gospel, majority remove God from those things. All about that inner voice you have, that inner voice, faith in faith. How strong, what can I muster up to prove I'm saved, or what, or how can I show myself approved? Not about God coming, not about, I mean, wrong, don't hear the word, oh, I got a word from the Lord, and things of that nature. Usually that's their own word, like they heard it themselves, what they deciphered, what they came up with, and things of that nature. It's not, man, I saw a baptism today, I saw God come down on a person and bestow his promises and gifts to that person. You won't hear that type of talk in the American gospel. It's all about you. Faith in faith. How strong can I be? I mean, just look at this. Majority of people who hold the American gospel view baptism as, oh, it's their choice. It's their first act of obedience. Notice it's all about that person. It's what they did, what they came to, what they grasped, what they intellectually achieved by their faith. Like, it's not God giving you faith. It's not, it's sad. It's that the American gospel, we really have took and misplaced a lot of things that are of essential importance in the faith.